here to bake up a delicious spring vegetable quiche that will be the star of your next brunch for sure. Welcome back, our good friend, Chef Judy Joo.
Hello.
Thank you.
Joining Cam at the counter is Kimmy and Paige. They're all looking forward to making this weekend. Another thing you can add to your list to make for Vanessa and the kids.
I just want to say that real men eat quiche. That's all.
Yeah, real men eat quiche.
I don't know where, there's a quote from something. I can't remember. But it's from somewhere.
From somewhere. And if it's not, it's from your mouth.
I love that.
So quiche is very impressive and equally delicious, but a lot of people don't make it because it seems intimidating. But you say this is so easy.
So easy. It's actually even easier when you buy the crust.
Exactly. Yes. That's the little tip.
Yes, exactly.
So there's so many great pre-made, store-bought crusts now. Everything. You don't have to take the time to actually make your own.
Yeah, you just go to your freezer section, and there are lots of organic ones. They're made with real butter, so they're nice and savory, and you're sorted.
You're ready to go.
Yeah, and then you can make two because it's so easy.
And then it's really just a dump and go.
Definitely, definitely.
We talk a lot about blind baking here, and we kind of joke that you put on a blindfold and then put the pie in the oven. That's not exactly what you do. So will you explain to everyone exactly what blind baking is?
Blind baking is basically you just have to bake the crust before you actually bake the actual dish.
So it's pre-baking.
It's pre-baking. But the thing is that you always have to put pie weights in it because it'll puff up and you'll have a dome. I've done that before in my youth. And so you're like trying to push it down. You're like, why does it puff up? So you just take a piece of parchment paper and you can use pie weights. You can buy them or just dried beans.
In a bowl and just put them in there.
And you just dump them in.
I didn't know what you were talking about. Pie weights. And I was like, what are we talking about?
Pie weights are a thing.
Yeah, they
but are. You don't have to go out and buy pie weights. You have a bag of beans. Just make sure you take the beans out of the bag because you don't want plastic melting.
Oh,
exactly. Just FYI.
Dip.
Exactly. So how long would we put that in there for?
We put that in there according, just probably about 10 to 15 minutes, but just look at the package instructions because everybody has their own.
A pretty high heat though, right?
Yes,
it goes
fast. And it's fast,
Okay,
exactly.
So now we have our par-baked pie.
Exactly.
So we'll set that aside and we'll start to saute.
I need that.
Oh, we need this?
Well, I need this. We gotta get rid of this.
On the side.
Yeah, now you gotta get rid of this. There you go.
And then you can make some beans later if you'd
like. Exactly. Yeah.
They're already pre-made.
Exactly. Exactly.
So now we are going to saute all of our spring vegetables.
Yes. Do you want to help saute?
Sure. You tell me
what to do. Or do you want to dump?
Oh, I'll dump for you.
You dump? Okay. I'll do the stir. You do the dump.
Okay.
So just some butter.
Stir it with some yummy butter.
Yes, exactly. Oh,
there you go.
Here we go.
I was using
You're getting involved. I like it.
Well,
you're getting, using your hands. Yeah. So we're getting this little special twist here is that we're going to make a miso butter.
Isn't that awesome?
Yeah, so miso is one of the great ingredients coming out of Asia, and not all misos are created equal, so do taste it. You can use red miso if you want to, but be careful. It has a bit of a stronger flavor. Here we're just using some shiro or white miso.
Okay.
Break it down like that.
I mean, I'd have to imagine that putting butter in miso would be great base for any sort of sauce, because it's really umami.
It's a umami bomb, so you're getting a lot of flavor in here. Yeah.
Does it take a long time for the miso paste to break down?
No, not really. Okay. Yeah, and especially with the moisture that's going to come from the vegetables, it really just dissolves.
So basically, this is one of those quiches. You go to the farmer's market on a Saturday or Sunday, and whatever they have, you use.
Yep, so here, because spring has sprung,
we
are going to use some nice asparagus and some spinach. But you can really, you know, quiche is kind of like a fried rice. Just throw in anything that you have in your fridge, you know, any kind of meats. You know, you got leftover bacon, you got some turkey, you have, you know, kale, you have, you know, peas or anything.
Mushrooms.
I may be the only one who doesn't know the answer to this, but is the difference between a frittata and a quiche, is it just the crust or is there a whole, it's a whole different thing?
Oh, frittata is a whole
thing.
Egg. Different thing.
Isn't it?
Good talk.
Does a frittata have a bottom?
Frittata has potatoes in it a lot of times. And sometimes they even have noodles.
It's sort of similar. It got really quiet and awkward here.
I mean,
I see it.
Well, no, it's not a bad question because you can see the shape is very similar. Just frittata. I've never had a frittata with a pie crust. I don't know if
that's what I mean. Is that the difference? The lack of crust.
I mean, they're brothers and sisters.
Okay,
exactly.
Same family.
They're cousins.
They're like cousins. Exactly.
I apologize to derail this cooking segment.
The quiche is the more elegant cousin of the frittata.
There you go.
The frittata. I love that.
Exactly.
Okay, so we've got that going. Look at that.
And now we pour in the eggs.
You're getting ahead of here.
We don't go to the eggs yet?
No, we got to put some milk or some cream in the eggs.
Okay.
There you go.
There you go. We whisk that together.
And then with some sesame seeds.
Why the sesame seeds?
You can put the whole thing in. I like that because it adds a really nice nutty flavor, some earthiness, and some texture. And you got to make your quiche a little bit different.
And it makes it a little Asian as well.
Exactly.
We've already put in the miso paste.
So we've spread out our vegetables evenly here. And then we're gonna put in the egg mixture.
Ooh, yummy.
Yum, yum, just like that. Oh. And let it kind of settle and go all around. Yeah. Really simple. And then we're gonna put some goat cheese in.
Oh. So
sprinkle that everywhere on top.
Okay, could you use any other kind of cheese?
Yeah, you can feta, whatever you want, cheddar. You know, I like the goat cheese with the spring vegetables because goat cheese loves spring vegetables, works really well. I just wanna submerge them a bit.
Okay.
Yeah, so that they're nice
and as you're
and
setting
in.
That up, and I'm sure you're gonna be putting it in the oven, I wanna ask you about your, hard at work on your book, Korean Soul Food, which
Korean
is coming out
soul
in October,
food.
Right?
Exactly. So that's coming out in October, both in the United Kingdom and the U.S. And it's really based on my cooking, which is really weird, I guess, because I'm trying to be an American Londoner.
Sounds
so
amazing.
It's kind of like my soul food.
It's very international.
Beautiful.
Exactly.
So how long does this go in for? Let me give you that, because that's still
might
be hot.
That's a little bit hot. Yes, yeah. Definitely. This goes in for about 40 to 45 minutes at 350. And that's
that.
The finished product. Oh, and a little bit of,
more sesame
flourish at the end. Here you go.
There it is.
And I will tell you, for me, quiche is great, hot, room temperature, or cold.
Absolutely.
The next day, straight out of the fridge, it's so delicious.
And it's also good for breakfast, lunch, or dinner.
This is true.
Because it's eggs or snacks, and it's so versatile.
It's so good.
Judy,
thank you so much. Super delicious. You guys have a bite and enjoy. Will I tell everybody that the full recipe will, of course, be at HallmarkChannel.com.